Hi students, welcome to Lucky Naresh Physics Channel. I am Naresh Babu, Physics Faculty. Students, in this session, I am going to discuss about mutual inductance of two long coaxial solenoids. Look at here. Let S1, S2 are the two solenoids having same length L, such that S2 surrounds S1. Let small n1, small n2 be the number of turns of solenoid S1 and S2 per unit length. First suppose, let I1 current is flowing through S1. Due to that, total magnetic flux linked with S2 is ∅21. So here I can write ∅21 is directly proportional to the current flowing through solenoid S1. That means total magnetic flux linked with solenoid S2 is directly proportional to the current flowing through the solenoid S1. If I remove directly proportional, I need to write constant. That constant I will write M21 into I1. M21 means mutual inductance of solenoid S2 with respect to solenoid S1. So this one I will consider equation 1. Here magnetic field strength inside a solenoid S1 is B1 equal to mu naught N1 I1. Magnetic field strength inside solenoid S1 due to I1 is B1 equal to mu naught N1 into I1. So here magnetic flux linked with each turn of coil S2 is magnetic flux linked with each turn of coil S2 is equal to B1 into area of cross section of coil S2. Total magnetic flux linked with S2 due to this magnetic field strength B1 inside a solenoid S1 is, look at here, total magnetic flux in S2 is ∅21 equal to B1 into A into N2. Capital N2 means here number of turns, L length of solenoid. Small n means number of turns per unit length of solenoid. So here I am calculating total magnetic flux in S2 due to magnetic field strength inside a solenoid S1 is, that is, ∅21 equal to B1A into N2. Here capital N2 means total number of turns in solenoid S2 which is having length small l. So look at here. From this I can write in the place of ∅21 from equation 1, what can I write? I can write M21 into I1. So, I will write M21 into I1. That equal to B1 means, what can I write? B1 means mu naught small n1 I1. Look at here, mu naught small n1 I1 into A n2. Okay. So, here both sides I1, I1 cancel. So, what I got? I got M21 is equal to mu naught instead of small n1. What can I write? I can write n1 by small l. How I got n1 by small l? Look at here. Look at here. See, one unit length contains small n number of turns. L unit length contains how many turns? That I will consider capital N. So, cross multiplication if you do means, you will get N1 equal to small N1 into L. So, from this, small N1 equal to capital N1 by L. So, I got in the place of small N1, capital N1 by L. So, I replaced in the place of N1, capital N1 by L into N2 into A. So, finally I got M21 equal to mu naught N1 into N2 A by L. Similarly, M12 equal to mu naught N1 N2 A by L. Look at here. Here I got mutual inductance of 2 with respect to 1. I got mu naught N1 N2 A by L. Similarly, mutual inductance of 1 with respect to 2 also, I got same one. That is mu naught N1 N2 A by L. So, from these two equations, I can say that M21 equal to M12. So, therefore, M21 equal to M12. That I will consider capital M. Therefore, I can write M equal to, capital M equal to mu naught N1 N2 A by L. So, I got mutual inductance of two long coaxial solenoids. That is, M equal to mu naught N1 N2 A by L. For suppose, if I used any core material, which is having magnetic permeability mu. So, I can replace here. See, if a core having magnetic permeability mu, then M equal to mu into N1 N2 A by L. Okay. Instead of mu, I can write relative magnetic permeability. What can I write? I can write M equal to, instead of mu, I can write mu r mu naught N1 N2 A by L. So, I got mutual inductance in terms of relative magnetic permeability. So, that's about mutual inductance of two long coaxial solenoids. Now, we will do numerical on mutual inductance. A 1 meter long solenoid with diameter 2 centimeter and 2000 turns has a secondary of 1000 turns wound closely near its midpoint. What will be the mutual inductance between two coils. What will be the mutual inductance between the two coils? Now I will write given data. Look at here. See, given a 1 meter long solenoid, that means L equal to 1 meter with a diameter 2 centimeter. Diameter 2 centimeter. From that I can find radius. R is equal to, radius R equal to D by 2, diameter by 2. That is equal to 2 by 2. So, you will get 1 centimeter. 1 centimeter means 10 power minus 2 meter. Okay? Next, N1 they have given 2000 turns. N1 equal to 2000 turns. And N2 they have given 1000 turns. N2 they have given 1000 turns. We need to find mutual inductance between the two coils. That is M equal to question mark. So we have formula for mutual inductance. That is M equal to mu naught N1 N2 A by L. Here mu naught means constant, that value 4 pi into 10 power minus 7 into N1 means 2000 into N2 means 1000, okay, into A means I can write pi R square by L means 1 meter. So now I will write here, that is equal to 4 pi. See, instead of pi, I will write 3.14. 3.14 into 10 power minus 7. 10 power minus 7 into, see, 2 into 1, 2. I will write 3 zeros here, 3 zeros here. I will write 10 power 6. 2 into 10 power 6 into pi means I can write 3.14 into R means, see, R 10 power minus 2. Here R square. So 10 power minus 2 whole square. That is 10 power minus 4. 10 power minus 4 by L1. So what I will get? Look at here. 4 into, instead of 3.14, I will write 3. Approximately, I will write 3. Okay. Then, 10 power minus 7, 10 power minus 4. That is 10 power minus 11 into 2 into 10 power 6 into 3.14, I will write approximately 3. By 1. No need to write. Okay. So 3 3 is 9. 9 2 is 18. 18 4s. 72 into 10 power minus 11, 10 power 6. 10 power minus 11, 10 power 6 means a power m into a power n. A power m plus n. That is equal to what will you get? 10 power minus 11 plus 6. Will get minus 5. So, I got 72 into 10 power minus 5 Henry. So, Henry is the SI unit for mutual inductance. So, that's about numerical. Students, in next session, we will discuss about AC generator. Thanks for watching my video. Please subscribe and click the bell icon for all notifications. Thank you.